Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. My dear brothers and sisters, assalamu alaykum jami'an wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Muslims sometimes ask the question whether it is permissible for us to consume beverages, foods, content that we eat or drink that contains alcohol. Let's look at the answer. We know that alcoholic beverages like wine, beer, vodka, these sorts of drinks are all prohibited. It is haram for us to consume them. In addition, we know that wine is also najis, it is also impure. Thus, if it comes into contact with something that is pure, it makes it mutanajis and it makes it impure until it is washed away. Hence, we know that not only is wine impure, but based on obligatory precaution, drinks like beer are also considered to be impure or najis. Hence, the contact of it with something that is pure, once again, will make that thing mutanajjis or will contract the najasa. In addition to that, we know that these alcoholic beverages are considered to be haram, forbidden to us, and it is explained that the main quality of them is that they intoxicate the individual. And hence, we understand the prohibition of it for us. Now, what about other substances? Things that contain alcohol, but may not be construed as alcoholic beverages. For example, a medication that has alcohol in it, or a vanilla extract that is often put into cookies or cakes that has some amount of alcohol content in it. Well, the alcohol that goes into, let's say, the vanilla extract, or even the medication, or even the types of alcohols that are found inside of perfumes and colognes are considered to be tahir. They are considered to be pure. They do not cause something to become mutanajjis. They do not cause something to become impure. However, their consumption is still prohibited. It is not allowed. The only exception to this rule is if the quantity of the alcohol in that substance is very, very low. So for example, let's say you have some vanilla extract and the composition or the quantity of alcohol in that vanilla extract is 3% or less by volume. And by virtue of the fact that you were to take a drop or maybe a capful of this vanilla extract and to put it into some batter or mix it into any larger volume of food item that you then make or you bake, and that volume of alcohol, 3% or less, becomes subsumed or deteriorates inside of the larger volume of food that is being produced, then in that case, it is permissible to consume. Again, recognizing that consumption of alcohol is prohibited. However, that the alcohols found in vanilla extract, in perfumes, in medications, those that are considered to be wood spirits are considered to be pure, tahir, unlike wine and beer based on obligatory precaution, which are prohibited to drink and are considered to be najis or impure. And to recognize that when the volume of the alcohol in the vanilla extract or the medicine is taken into consideration, that in general 3% or less is considered to be that amount that is considered acceptable to consume. Reach out to us with your questions and provide us with your feedback. Subscribe to our YouTube channel and I wish you all well. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.